is a specific segment. So many unknowns, and we make a lot of assumptions about a lot of these variables. So, N up here is the total number of civilizations. In order to find that out, several other variables that have to do with In front of a star during its orbit or its transit, that brightness decreases a fraction. We detect that. There's also a way called microlensing, where we look for stars that wobble because of the gravitational influence of its planetary bodies. So needless to say, pretty much every star, as far as we can tell, has planets. Now the next one gets a little trickier. This one represents, again, the number of these planets that could potentially harbor life. And in order to harbor life, at least as we know it, you have to have necessary to keep water liquid. And that's surprisingly pretty common. According to, again, the Kepler mission, and from what we can observe, based on the number of planets, exoplanets that we found that are Earth-like, it comes down to almost half. Questions is based off us, and that's not necessarily a great sample size. special circumstances. And this was a particularly tricky one. Of those planets that develop life, how many of them acquire intelligent life? Again, for Earth, it's one for one. Several billion years after life initially formed. So it might be difficult to really know. However, just using Earth as a model, we can assume for this liberal estimate. Is perhaps one of the most difficult questions to answer. How long can a civilization exist as a communicating civilization? Could it be a relatively long time, something like the liberal estimate would be 100,000 years? Sense for the last several decades. Before radio astronomy, we were quiet. Yes.